Most people believe their stress is primarily caused by two things, not enough time or not enough money, wouldn't you agree? But isn't what keeps us up at night the conflicts we have in our relationships, personal or professional? In fact, global studies research found 79% of employees who leave their job do so because they don't feel appreciated. People don't leave companies, they leave stressful bosses. You may have noticed in the middle of most conflicts, there's this emotional wave that hits you, causing you to forget any communication skills. Sound familiar? Most people grow up in families in which whenever there's a conflict, they don't end up closer, they end up farther apart. We're left feeling uncomfortable at best, hurt and angry at worst. We learn these relationship habits. We weren't born with them. And because we've learned these habits, whenever we anticipate a conflict, we stress out before anything happens. For instance, ever have an argument with someone who wasn't in the room? You're imagining an argument, having a nightmare while awake. But the stress was very real, wasn't it? I know. I also have this habit of imagining arguments that don't turn out the way I want. So what's the solution? How do we prevent ourselves from getting stressed in a conflict? It might help to reflect on one simple reality. Think about it this way. What percent of the disagreements you experience are caused by misunderstandings? There's no correct answer. Just get a number in your mind that you think might be true. Everyone we ask says it's at least 50%. Many say 75%, and some even say 90% of their disagreements are caused by misunderstandings. Now ask yourself, what percent of those arguments that are caused by misunderstandings, what percent of those were because you misunderstood? Your number probably went way down, right? If you didn't say 0%, then you're being generous. Because in the middle of an argument, we always think we're right. And what about the other person? We know they're wrong. And yes, we need to point out their mistakes by saying something like, hey, I'm just trying to be helpful. Don't want you to go down the wrong path. If so many disagreements are caused by misunderstandings, and it's highly unlikely that we're always as right as we think we are, then we might be part of the problem too. This is why it's so important to start noticing your stress quicker, catching that emotional wave before it crashes into you, and turning it quickly into the proactive stress response. Breathe, relax, reassure yourself, you know the rest. Be the person who reduces conflict instead of making it worse. As a psychologist, I'll have more to say about reducing the stress in professional and personal relationships in this program. But for now, I'd like to show you a short 3-minute video from one of my talks. It's about how to end conflict with 3 questions. After the video, I'll see you in lesson 8, where the rest of your life awaits. Enjoy the video and look for an opportunity to practice.